In a video on George's channel from July 8th, in which he said many things, including his first response to my entrance into the GG saga, George started off the video singing. Here's a reminder.
People are talking about me, don't care a word they're saying, and only the echoes of my mind. People stop and staring, seeing what the great man is going to say, and I only can say I'm what's causing all of this.
Something about that song choice resonated with me. It's taken this long to finally get that eureka moment, but this is the theme song for the film Midnight Cowboy.
Everybody's talking at me. I don't hear a word they're saying. Only the echoes of my mind.
People stop and stare, seeing what the great man is going to say. I only can say I'm what's causing all of this.
The song George is singing is Everybody's Talkin', which was recorded by singer Harry Nilsson for the film. Fun fact, the song won a Grammy. The film itself also won several awards, including Best Picture, Best Director, and Best Screenplay at the Oscars. I genuinely recommend watching it. It's a brutal story and a gritty film, but still a great piece of art. But George singing that song made me ponder about the film's plot, and a very interesting parallel with George occurred to me. Midnight Cowboy follows two men, with two distinctly different personalities. Who else do we know that has shown signs of having two distinctly different personalities? So here's a snapshot of these two characters from the film Midnight Cowboy. You tell me if either sound familiar. First, there's Joe, played by John Voight. Joe sees himself as a cowboy, an alpha male. He styles himself as a ladies' man, so much so that he moves to New York, convinced he'll find success in being a male prostitute, because the ladies love him. Spoiler alert, he doesn't. But Joe is hampered by a dark past. He was accused of raping a woman he loves, and he can't escape the guilt. He was abandoned by his mother when he was young, leading to an unhealthy disposition with women. Then there is Ratso, the second character, who is played by Dustin Hoffman. Ratso is a tiny, poor, disheveled inhabitant of a city and a world too big for him. He walks with a limp. He is altogether physically and emotionally broken. His health is deteriorating because he doesn't have the faculties to take care of himself. Out of self-preservation, he's a compulsive liar and a con man. When he meets John Voight's character Joe, he finds comfort in hiding behind him. The two starkly different men end up forming a strange but tight bond. First they use each other, then they resent each other, they become reliant on each other, and finally they become attached to one another. Does George love this film? Do you think this is something that really connects with him? That's just my thought of the day.